Hey everyone, it's your buddy Graphic back with another video, and today I'm going to be talking about the fastest really leveling methods in New World. So when you're loading up in the New World, you're going to see a bunch of different things happening. Obviously in the top right, you're going to see rested XP bonus. For those of you who don't know this, it's a massive tip to understand to stay in settlements when, you know, if you go into bed for the night, go into a settlement, rest there, because if you look at the bottom of this board before we get into the fastest XP leveling, I want to talk about this major tip. So like I said, guys, most of you guys may know this, but in the very bottom here, you can see right below the We Are Investigating server instability in this world, you can see that there is a little small gray bar. If you can see my mouse, I'm not sure if you can see my mouse actually, but you should be able to see a small gray bar, and it's basically rested XP, so you will be gaining double, I don't know if it's double XP, you'll be getting a lot more XP until that bar is full. So make sure to, you know, end your night in a settlement. And obviously, if you're going away for a while, you know, ending in a settlement is a great way to make sure you're going to get that rest XP when you come back. So there's a couple different ways of leveling, and we're going to talk about, like I said, the fastest today. So we have syndicate quests, we have, you know, PvP missions there, PvE missions there, we have town projects, we have side quests, we have main quests, right? So we have a bunch of different options when leveling in New World. You can also just run around and PvP. So if we go over to the Syndicate faction quest, you can actually open the faction board and see that there are PvE missions. These actually scale based on the area that you're in. So the best thing to do is actually there are bonuses as well. So you have to take into consideration the bonuses that you will be getting. You know, when you see here at the top left is actually what I'm going to show you guys is the daily bonuses available. So 0 of 3. So when that is filled to 3 of 3, make sure to do your missions that day, because like I said, you will get best XP when those daily bonuses are available to you. So right now I have 0 of 3, but if I had 3 of 3, my next 3 missions would be massive XP bonuses to those 3 missions, and it does reset daily. And one thing to note is, you know, there are PvE and PvP missions, and they scale based on the area you're in. So right now I am in Everfall, and there's also obviously other settlements out there. You know, Brightwatch, we have, you know, if we go over here, I couldn't even think of the name for a second, but we have Weaver's Fen. There's a lot of options you can go to, and obviously XP usually does scale with those higher, you know, higher zones. So even when you're doing town projects, there's higher XP available for you there, and there's also higher syndicate faction missions there for you. So let's get into the fastest leveling. So the first thing I'll say is, if you're focused on weapon mastery, that is a little bit separate, and we're going to talk about that first just because that's an easy one to answer. Weapon mastery, I have rapier, you know, 17 mastery, fire staff 7, or sorry, 11, and we have musket 13. Just started leveling the fire staff, and I got it to 11 in probably an hour or two, probably an hour, and it was just because it was just, you know, PvP. PvP is an amazing way to get that mastery up. It doesn't level your character up as fast as quests would or town projects would. However, you're getting your mastery up, and mastery is huge for PvP players. So make sure to PvP, obviously, to get you know, better stats for PvPing. So rapier, I have 17 of 20 already, and a lot of people at level 32 probably don't have 17 of 20 on their rapier unless they're doing a lot of PvP. So make sure to understand that, you know, to get better rapier mastery, or, you know, get better weapon mastery in general, PvP is a very, very big aspect. It gives you a huge amount of XP when you kill somebody, depending on how long they've been alive. So, you know, I've gotten anywhere from 1,500 XP, I believe, or, you know, I think it was, yeah, 1,500 XP, weapon mastery XP from one kill, I believe I got the other day. So unless I'm misunderstood, but, you know, I did get at least 800 a few times for weapon mastery. So it can be pretty, pretty crazy. For each kill, if you didn't know, outside of, you know, PvP, you can get about 20 XP at most from weapon mastery, it seems like, in, you know, typical range at this level. So we're going to talk about town projects next, because this is where actually you will level up the fastest. And I know a lot of people are waiting for me to talk about this last. I'm not going to talk about this last. I'm going to talk about it right now. So this is, like I said, the fastest way to level up, in my opinion, easily. So right now you can see that my XP right now is, you know, about 32 and a quarter, and that's strictly because of town projects, I feel like. Town projects, I've done so many of them because they are such fast rewards. So some of these are very, very easy. So hunt 5 wolves, it only gives you 420 XP. So you're going to have to look at these and see which ones give you a lot of XP. So in Everfall, you're not going to have as crazy XP, but here we have cook and deliver dairy supplies. So if you're able to cook and deliver this, it's 5,070 XP. And that is not including if you go to your map and you actually go to your territory standing. If you go to Everfall, I have 15 seen standing in Everfall. You can actually go see, and you have XP gain, I have XP gain, I should say, of 10.3% more XP gain while in Everfall. So if I turn that in, I'm going to get 10% on top of that 5,070 XP, which is a ton of XP altogether. And there's a lot of these kind of, you know, easy to do missions out there. So 15 common mana potions, 2,600 XP. That's a full quest. I mean, a very good quest at that. And it could take you seconds to go to the town project, refresh some. So like, let's say I don't want five wolves because it's only 420 XP, right? So we refresh it. It's not five links. So now I just have to hunt 10 links. I could come back and turn these in. Obviously, I'd want to turn in the top one because the top one would actually give me more, or basically double the XP as that bottom one. So that's another thing to look into when you're doing this as well. But town projects, if you guys haven't been doing them, a lot of them you can actually just buy as well. So let's say we go up here. We see 15 common mana potions. Right now, those are probably kind of expensive, but it's 2,600 XP. So we'll see what that is in the market right now because, like I said, there is sometimes, you know, very, very cheap deals on there where you can just get 250 water, let's say. And water obviously being a very, very cheap thing to get. But let's go to mana potions, common mana potions, and see if there's any cheap ones. So I don't even know how many I needed. I think I needed 15. So we'll just buy 15. And if I'm wrong, we'll go back and we'll check it out. But let's go to buy 15 real quick and just kind of give you guys an understanding of how easy this is. Obviously, you just have to spend a little bit of gold. But a lot of us probably have a lot of extra gold right now. It depends what you're doing with your gold. But that must not have been it because it's not lighting up green for me. Must have been more than 15 or I might be using the wrong mana potion. I did not start it yet. So that's what it is. So let's click deliver mana potions. Instantly it goes to complete, and look at that. I can complete it. I get 3,322 XP from just buying that XP pretty much with gold. So it's just insane. It's definitely the fastest way right now. A lot of people abusing it, and I would definitely take advantage of this during the beta. I do think they'll nerf it during the actual release of the game. So definitely take advantage, like I said, of the Town Projects board right now. Another great way to level up is obviously the main quest. Main quest is huge for leveling up. So definitely take advantage of the main quest whenever you can. If you can continue on your main quest, you probably should continue on your main quest. Another thing is side quests. Side quests are actually better than faction missions. After your first three faction missions can be more fun. It depends, obviously, on you or your group that you're playing with. But faction missions may be the most fun for you. You can definitely do them. It's still great XP. However, side quests at these top top zones are much, much better, in my opinion, than those Syndicate or Marauder or Covenant faction quests. So make sure to take advantage of those side quests in those higher zones because, like I said, great, great things unlock as well as obviously more XP as well. So just huge opportunities here. Definitely take advantage of your three daily bonuses, like I said, on the faction missions. I just want to give you guys a quick kind of idea of what's the fastest leveling. And do remember that crafting also gains XP. A lot of people don't realize that you can actually go craft and it'll actually give you XP overall. So if we go over here to the kitchen, I don't know if I can cook anything right now. Let's say I cook some, I don't really want to get rid of my onion right now, but let's get rid of, I don't even know. Let's see. We don't really need tomatoes much right now. So we'll just do cook five of these. We'll actually use blueberries as well. So we're going to cook seven. And we have onion selected again. So let me reselect apples, I guess. We'll go with apples. So we'll do seven light meals real quickly. So obviously when I do light meals, it will give me 280 XP right there onto my 32. So I'm getting closer to 32 and a half right now in level. And I just wanted to give you guys kind of a brief understanding of how leveling works in this game and really the fastest methods in my opinion. Right now, Town Projects easily takes the cake. So definitely take advantage of that. If you're looking for weapon mastery, do PvP. It's the fastest, it's the most fun in my opinion, obviously as a PvPer, but it's very, very fast XP, and you can definitely take advantage of that very, very easily. So just want to give you guys a brief understanding, and that will be all for today's video. I just want to kind of, like I said, give you the fastest leveling XP. Make sure to quickly subscribe to the channel, turn notifications on, and like the video, guys. As I said, I will be doing a lot of new world content as we continue to move forward.